Today we discuss about Ayub Khan. His term in office started from 1958 till 1969. As we have started earlier, that after the political turmoil of 1958, on 24 October 1958, Mirza appointed Ayub Khan as a prime minister. And on 27th October, he forced Mirza to resign and exile him to London. In 1958, he declared martial law and abrogated 1956 constitution, dismissed government and dissolved the national and provincial assemblies. Now, the introduction of Ayub Khan. Ayub Khan was born in 1907 in Hazara, the Indian district. After getting education from Aligarh Muslim University, he joined British Royal Military College. In World War II, he was appointed as a second commander of the regiment in Burma and commanded the Battalion of India. After partition in 1947, he served in Pakistan Army as a major general. And in 1958, he became the president of Pakistan. Today we discuss about Ayub Khan tenure, successes and failure. Successes in 1962 constitution. He introduced positive reform in which there was a land reform, industrial reform, wealth increase. That is why his time duration was called the decade of development. He also defended in 1965 war against India. So today we discuss his successes, and then later on in next classes, inshallah, failures. Failures, 1965 war, unable to resolve Kashmir issue, negative reforms we discuss, and then a presidential form of government which did not like most of the Pakistani and curtailing civil liberties. So today we discuss constitutional reform. In October 1959, the President Ayub Khan issued the Basic Democracies Order. It was a four-tier structure in which people were involved in different levels of decision making. The four-tier structure would consist of a village college, a village council at the most basic level, a sub-district council, a district council, and a divisional council, the local district magistrate and the divisional commissioners would act as a chairman of the local bodies. Under this system, 40,000 basic democrats were to be elected by the local bodies. Later, the basic democrats increased to 80,000. It also consists of an electoral college for the election of the president and the member of the provincial and national assemblies. Means these elected peoples were allowed to vote for the president and the member of the provincial and national assemblies. Only these electorate college were allowed to vote, not the other political party and the individual person. On the basis of this system, 1962 constitution was imposed and enforced. Okay? And it is a presidential form of government who was authorized to appoint governor of the provinces. Yani president would authorize to appoint governors and for the provinces as well, who in turn would appoint the ministers of the cabinet. Okay? The governor then appoint the minister of the cabinet. It was also given to the power of veto the law passed. Any president would also given the power to veto. Veto power means to oppose any law. So this is a structure of government, four tiers government structure. Thi. Number one is basic democracies, yani BDs. This system was designed to accomplish multiple political objectives. That is, it was accepted that in this method, so many people would involve, especially in rural areas, for the development activities of the for the countries. Okay, and the basic democracy organization is a four-tier structure. और ये है फर्स्ट वन था द यूनियन काउंसिल इट वाज द लोएस्ट बट द बेसिक टायर ऑफ द सिस्टम The Union Council consists of 5 to 8 villages, about 88,000 to 15,000 population ki honi chahiye thi, 10 to 15 elected people, electorate people selected, and then after that one select for Union Council through this through the election or voting. ठीक है, दीज रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज इनकी क्या थी? द यूनियन काउंसिल इलेक्टेड मेंबर की ज्यूडिशियल, इकोनॉमिकल, एग्रीकल्चर डेवलपमेंट एंड फूड प्रोडक्शन इन देयर रिस्पेक्टिव एरिया. इन द सेम वे सेकेंड था द तहसील काउंसिल. द नेक्स्ट हायर टायर है, देयर वॉज नो इलेक्शन फॉर दिस काउंसिल. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ सम ऑफिशियल एंड सम नॉन ऑफिशियल मेंबर्स. ठीक है, इट वॉज हेडेड बाय असिस्टेंट कमिश्नर ऑफ द एरिया. देन अनदर थर्ड लेवल इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट लेवल, दैट इज द डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल. द हेड ऑफ द काउंसिल वॉज द डिप्टी कमिश्नर, और इसके जो थे ये इट वॉज ऑल्सो इलेक्टेड बाय द काउंसिल मेम्बर्स एज वेल, ऑफिशियल और नॉन ऑफिशियल. इसका फंक्शन क्या था? द परफॉर्म वास्ट फाइनेंशियल एंड एग्जीक्यूटिव पावर. तो देयर इज अ डिफरेंट सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. ठीक है, दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर. लोअर द यूनियन काउंसिल, विच आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू, द विलेज काउंसिल थी. देन सेकेंड नंबर पे तहसील एंड थाना, डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल, नॉन ऑफिशियल मेंबर थे, ऑफिशियल और नॉन ऑफिशियल मेंबर्स थे, इक्वल नंबर्स ऑफ ऑफिशियल एंड नॉन ऑफिशियल मेंबर, इनके डिफरेंट टास्क थे. देन जिला, डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल एंड देन डिविजन एडवाइजरी काउंसिल. तो दिस इज द बेसिक डेमोक्रेसीज ही इंट्रोड्यूस फर्स्ट. इट इज अ प्रेजिडेंशियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एंड देन ही इंट्रोड्यूस 1962 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अच्छा, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रिफॉर्म. इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन उर्दू एंड बंगाली वर रिकग्नाइज एज अ नेशनल लैंग्वेज एंड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पार्शली वॉज इम्प्लीमेंटेड, दैट इज इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन बिटवीन ईस्ट पाकिस्तान एंड वेस्ट पाकिस्तान. No doubt, they were aimed to greater participation of the local people for decision making. But these reforms invited lots of criticism. बहुत सारे criticism face करना पड़ा, since they concentrated lots of power in the hand of the president. That is why it faced criticism, because most of the power resented with the president, which people did not want or like. Moreover, East Pakistani too demanded greater share in the seats on the behalf of their greater population, which was not granted to them. Equal representation was accepted in this constitutional reform. Constitution of 1962. Mr. Ayub Khan announced the constitution on March 1, 1962, and after that, election to the national and the provincial assemblies were held in April and May 1962 respectively, and the second constitution was in force on 8 June 1962, and after that martial law was lifted from the country. General Ayub Khan wanted to introduce a controlled and limited democracy, as he believed that Western style democracy did not suit Pakistan. Therefore, he introduced the Constitution of 1962 on 1st March, thereby abrogating the previous Constitution. Previous Constitution ko unhone end kar diya and introduced a new Constitution with the provision which suggested a controlled democracy. Main feature of 1962 Constitution kya the? Presidential form of government, basic democracy introduced, principle of maximum provincial autonomy yani power, equality of mankind, independence of judiciary, right of minorities were accepted. Islamic advisory council was constituted to advise government over Islamic law making. Salient feature of 1962 constitution. Number one, written constitution. The constitution of 1962 was a written document. It consists of 3 schedules and 250 articles. Rigid constitution means a constitution can only be amended through a particular process. Like if an amendment to the constitution is passed by at least 2/3 majority of the parliament, then it become a part of a law after authentication by the president. third is federal system. A federal system was introduced in the country. It consisted of central government and two provincial government comprising East and West Pakistan. Presidential form of government. President was the head executive of the nation. He was empowered to nominate the ministers of his cabinet. Unicameral legislature means singular body. Okay? Not bicameral. Bicameral means two chamber and unicameral one chamber parliament. Indirect method of election. The president was elected by the electoral college comprising 80,000 basic Democrats equally distributed between the two provinces. Other features means provincial government. There would be two provinces, provincial government. Each of them was headed by the governor. Two constituency, one is for East Pakistan and one for West Pakistan. Achha, the provincial governor enjoy power in the provinces, whereas the president enjoy in the center. The governor was empowered to appoint provincial ministers with the sanction of the president of Pakistan. Yani governor was empowered or the to appoint provincial ministers. The governor of the provinces then appoint provincial ministers. Then provincial legislator, each province was provided with a legislator. Legislator means they can make a law in their province. It originally consists of 150 members. Okay? However, later on this number was increased to 218. Yani both the each provinces mein 150 members se previously and then increased to 218 members for each. Power of president according to 1962 constitution, the president would be a Muslim hona chahiye. Restriction and power for the Muslim for the president elected for the term of 5 years. 5 year ki term ke liye elect hote the. He was eligible to promulgate ordinance and veto against legislated law. Yani he was eligible to introduce any ordinance or law and also reject any law passed by the assembly. Assembly needed to be get the approval of the president if they wanted to make any law. Then however, the president was not empowered to dissolve the assembly except the cost of his office also. Yani wo khali assembly dissolve nahi kar sakte the. He himself dissolve the assembly at the cost of himself as well. Apna aapko bhi resignation dena padta. Restriction for to the president elected by electorate college by basic Democrats. This is the restriction thi ke only electorate college or basic Democrats elect the president. Then Islamic law, no law would be passed against the teaching of Quran and Sunnah and the existing law would be made Islamic in charter. Yani Islamic law hona chahiye Pakistan mein. Fundamental rights were granted. Then the constitution of 1962 laid down the fundamental right of speech and expression, freedom to choose profession and freedom to profess religion, civil rights, all civil rights like right to live, right to purchase or sale property, all were granted. Okay? Role of judiciary. Judiciary was responsible for the interpretation of law and executive order in the light of the principle embodied in the written constitution. The written constitution mein likha hua hai, according to that, judiciary would play his role independently. Okay, the Islamic provision given in the constitution that the state of Pakistan shall be an Islamic Republic under the name of Islamic Republic of Pakistan according to the principle of policy. Steps were to be taken to enable the Muslims of Pakistan individually and collectively to order their lives in accordance with the fundamental principle of Islam. Yani, it is written in the constitution that a Muslim would lead their life according to the principle of Islam. Only a Muslim could be qualified for the election as a president. Teaching of the Quran and Islamia to the Muslim of Pakistan was made compulsory in schools and colleges. Then proper organization of zakat and masajid was ensured. Then practical steps were to be taken to eradicate whatever seen in social evils by Islam, such as the use of alcohol, gambling, etc. There shall be an organization to be known as Islamic Research Institute, which shall be established by the president. The function of the institute was to undertake Islamic research and instruction in Islam for the purpose of existing in the reconstruction of Muslim society on a true Islamic basis. So, these Islamic provisions were also introduced in constitution which needed to be implemented in the country. So this is the end of today. Today we discuss about the constitutional reform. In the next class, inshallah, we will study the other reform introduced by Ayub Khan. So till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.